depth. Never mind. I am going to do a green look, the upper part, and then a colorful bottom, basically. Hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, my name is Nikki. I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today my thoughts and three looks with the Zodiac Taurus palette. So this is what she looks like. The look that I have is look number 3. So you will see that at the end of the video. In case you don't know what she looks like inside, this is her inside. Looks really, really pretty. I will swatch her in a minute and then I will give you my final thoughts. After that, we will segue into the three looks basically. That is it. So this is the fourth mini Zodiac palette that I have from BH now. I have them all except the first one, which was Capricorn, I believe. Probably going to get that one someday as well. Or something, you know, just to complete the collection. Yes, but yeah, this is what she looks like. I will swatch her in a minute. I will go with this one, it's the first one, then I will go up and then I'll go like that counterclockwise, because I like swatching that way. So let me do that first before I go before I go any further. So yeah, let me get my makeup wipes ready and I'm going to start with the big highlighter. Not the most pretty swatches, and I made a boo-boo here. I started swatching with the wrong finger. This one was a little bit patchy. I built it up. This one was I built up as well because it was so light. I wanted you to see it. The patchiness on this one just kind of means that I work with it a little bit differently. I build a shade like that up instead of pack it on and then blend it out, or I use it on a set base. This palette kind of tricks you. If you look at this one, you think, it's a little bit boring. If you look at this one, you think, it's a little bit boring. It's a little bit gray, but both these shades are so pretty. They have a shift in them. They are gorgeous. This one, this is the dark as you can get it. So if you want to deepen up a look, you need to use this one. So yeah, overall, the quality is amazing. The same with all the mini Zodiac palettes. I do like the color story. Again, I just wish that they would have had one or maybe even two mattes, like they have in the Aries palette. They only have three, two shimmers and then the highlighter, two shimmers, and then the rest of the eyeshadows are mattes. I prefer that kind of balance, you know, but that's me personally. The only one that you kind of need to watch a little bit for is this one, because if you pack it on, or at least if I pack it on then blend it out, it can get patchy really quickly. That is why I prefer to work, as I said, the other way around, or use it on a set base. But yeah, that's basically it. It's not the same as the Pisces palette, because the Pisces is more blue based. So I know some of you are wondering, the Pisces versus the Taurus, so I have them both here. Here they are side by side. Can I see what I'm doing? Yes. So here is the Taurus and here is the Pisces. And as you can see, they are both different. I will also put a picture up so you can see them side by side. I also swatched them side by side. They are on my Instagram, but I will insert the picture as well, so you can see the difference. But yeah, I do want to pair them together because I think that they complement each other really, really nicely. And I think you can create gorgeous looks using both. I do think that they are trying really hard to make each palette unique, but also a companion palette. And I think they are, yeah, for me, they are succeeding so far. Could they have made it any more exciting? Sure they can, but you know, don't forget that the part of the population that uses very bold and bright colors is smaller than the part that does not. So yeah, I see that they are trying to make everyone happy. You cannot make everyone happy, you just cannot. But still, I personally really, really like the palettes, and I think they are getting better and better every time. Yeah, I think it is a nice addition to my collection. I don't really. The looks that I created with it are quite fast and easy looks. It is just, I don't know, the vibe I'm in lately. Fast and easy looks, not no cut creases, too complicated, you know, that kind of thing. I do think that you can create very gorgeous Instagram-worthy looks with this one as well. I just don't particularly feel like doing them at the moment, if I'm being totally honest with you. Is it worth its money? Yes, I think that at least the minis that I have are all worth their money. Just, you know, see if you can get them on sale, because they have sales going on all the time. And I am really, really curious to see, well, what the other color stories are going to be. I'm hoping for yellow, I'm hoping for an orange. Maybe we can get a purple as well. We had a red. So, yeah. I'm actually really excited to see, well, what else they will do. So, this was the review part. If you just want to see the review part, thank you so, so much for watching. If you want to see the looks, well, here they come. And let's get started with, well, the way we always do it, look number one. It would be fun if I start with look number three. Huh. Anyway, have fun watching the looks and let me know down below which one is your favorite. Okay, the first look with the Zodiac Taurus. I want to do something green, basically. So I want to use this one. And I don't know if I will keep it kind of in the green family and pull in this one and that one, or maybe I will go green gold. I don't know yet. I don't have a lot of time for this look, so it's going to be pretty simple because I have to go to work in a minute. So yeah, I'm going to start with a fluffy brush and that nice bright green color, and that's going to go on my lid. It's a bit powdery, so tap off excess. I haven't set my base as I usually do not. Let me pull my mirror in a bit closer so I can see what I'm doing. That's always nice. I'm going to tap it on. Okay. So I need a little bit more. Ah, that's better. There we have it. Oh, such a pretty, pretty bright green. These kinds of shades make me happy. I'm dipping lightly in that green to blend the edge. I want it underneath my eye as well. I'm taking a smaller brush, same green though. I'm going to kind of intensify the crease. I'm going to pull it on top of my eyelid as well. I am going to pull in this shade, which is very pretty. It is a yellowy gold. I've sprayed it. It's going to go on my lid. I think the shade is gorgeous. I want it. And yes, I can do a monochromatic green look as well. You can do so many looks with this palette. This is actually a really nice color story, or at least I think so. I want a tiny, tiny bit of depth. I'm going to go into this green, the darker green, with a small brush to kind of deepen up the outer corner a bit to create a little bit of extra depth. Because for my eye shape, I think that's prettier. So I'm basically just pretending that I did a cut crease. Okay, I'm going to blend that out with a tiny bit of that darker green. Yes, okay. Inner corner highlight. I think I'm going to go with the big green thing in the middle, that one. I'm going to pull it a little bit on top of my mobile lid as well. And let's flip it here. I haven't used it as a face highlight though. For my waterline, the ColourPop Pencil in Punch. For eyeliner, the Easy Tattoo Liner from Catrice. For mascara, the Catrice Glam & Doll in Waterproof. For falsies, the 3D Glam in style L12. For lipstick, the Catrice Generation Matte in Nude Town Express. And then that will complete the look. So here is the finished look. Nice and springy or summery or whatever you want to call it. I think it complements my shirt nicely. So let me go up so you can see my shirt. I think I did good. I had a lot of fun with this first look. Let me know down below what you thought of the look. And let's get ready for look number two. Okay. Look number two with the Taurus palette. And you cannot see, but I am also... I thought let's kind of go with the backing of the... never mind. I am going to do a green look. But I am going to do kind of a grungy cool tone green look. I'm going to start with this color, which is the gray, dark gray, a green, grayish matte, and a fluffy brush. Yes. Which is actually not really a good brush, but I like it anyway. I'm going to build the color up slow. Let's see what it does. My base is still tacky, so it could be that I want to set it with a bit of powder. But let's see what it does first. I'm going to place it quite low. I'm basically going to set my eyeshadow primer with the shadow. That's the idea. Stretching my eyelid, still tapping. Now I'm lightly sweeping back and forth. Very, very, almost no pressure on my eye. Okay, a little bit more, and I'm actually going to alternate between this one and then a tiny bit of that one to get a little bit of a nice color blend going. I'm going to use that on the top edge to blend it out a little bit. I want a little bit more of that brighter green. Yes, I thought so. So it is a tiny bit patchy. I will fix it. First, I'm going to kind of place that bright green. Blend it down a bit. I probably should have set my eyeshadow, but it is what it is. Going back into that dark green with the same brush. I'm going to intensify it in the lower crease. Just placing it. I will blend it out in a minute. Doing circles. I'm not staying too long in one place. Okay, switching to a smaller brush in that dark green color to intensify the outer corner and just make sure that I have a nice dark green layer in the crease behind the shimmer shade I will put on in a minute. Just making sure it's not patchy basically. Okay. Taking a bigger fluffy brush, it's clean. Just going to blend everything together. This is a really, really soft brush. I'm taking that dark shadow, dark green, a little bit underneath my eye as well, just in the outer corner. And then I'm kind of connecting it up and flicking it in. With this brush, I am going to take that bright green. The bright green matte, that one, it's going to go on my lower lash line. And I'm pressing it on because I want it to be bright green there, basically. I'm also blending it a bit. Bigger brush. Just for the edge. I want a little bit of that bright green on the tip of that brush. To kind of, you know, smoke it out a little bit. Hopefully kind of hide my under eyes a bit. I have a flat brush. I'm going to go into this grayish green shimmer. I'm going to spray. Let's plot that on the eye. Oh, such a pretty color. Now, I haven't done a cut crease, but I'm kind of pretending like I did. So I'm trying to make the line nice and crisp. Bring it all the way in. Such a pretty, pretty color. Oh, wow. I'm taking a little bit of that dark green matte for the outer corner here. I'm just going to blend the two together a bit. Oh my lord, I love this green. I am missing something on my lower lash line. What? Oh, I think that's it. Okay, so what I did is probably not a good idea. I'm actually taking my finger. It's not a good idea. In the highlighter shade, and I'm running that underneath my eye. Now, if you have sensitive eyes, don't do this. Otherwise, just grab a brush or sponge tip. I'm wearing contact lenses, and they make my eyes a little bit less sensitive to this kind of stuff. It's not a good idea, but I can do it. So I'm basically just running it on top of my waterline. That was what I was missing. Okay, inner corner highlight. Let's just plop a little bit of that highlighter, the center highlighter on. Bring it a little bit on top of the inner corner, so it kind of ties in together, you know? I like it a lot. Okay, let me grab that big fluffy brush and just go over everything one last time. Ooh, I like this one. For eyeliner, the Maybelline Lasting Drama Eyeliner in black. I'm keeping the eyeliner close to my actual lashes. So it's more tight lining, but then on the upper eyelid, above my lashes. For mascara, the Catrice Glam and Doll Waterproof. For falsies, the 3D Glam in style L12. For lipstick, the Carity the Matte in whatever. And that is it for the look. I don't know if I have a good falsie day. So if they are a bit wonky, it's that. Anyway, I really like how it turned out. I think the lippy pairs nicely with it. I like the darker, foresty, grungy green look. I like it. Let me know down below what you think of it. And let's get ready for the last look. So the last look with the Taurus palette. It's going to be a pretty simple look because my arm is, I don't know what it's doing, but it's not fun. I am going to start with a shimmer this time. I'm going to start with this one. And then the plan is to, well, blend it out with a matte. Probably the brown because I haven't used that one just yet. But let's see. First, let's grab the shimmer. I am going to spray. This is just going to go on my eyelid. Very pretty color. And this is a brown with a greenish shift. Or something. Very pretty. Okay. Let's just a little bit there in the outer corner. I'm getting a fluffy brush and the brown matte in the palette, this one. And I'm going to blend it out with that. This is a pretty light color by the looks of it. It's going to maybe pull a little bit orange. I know I'm not hating it though, so that's good. I'm cleaning the brush and just going over the edge to blend it into the skin. Again, it's going to be a simple look today. Actually, I'm first tapping the color on and then blending it out because I haven't set my base. And then just go windshield wiper motion, circles, that kind of thing. I'm changing brushes. Oh, here it is. To a clean, very soft brush. Okay. Let's get a little of that brown matte underneath the eye as well. Quite low. And this could basically be an eye look. And I'm not hating it. I do, however, want to deepen up my outer corner a little bit. So I'm going to grab the dark green that's in here. Because that shade is just darker than the brown I just used. I'm going to darken up the outer corner a bit. At least that's the idea. I don't want a really dark look. I just want a bit of depth on the outer corner. And then with whatever I have left, I'm bringing forward in the crease. Just lightly. Inner corner highlight. I'm going to pull it on top as well, as I usually do. I have here the eyeliner in Go Green from Essence. It's a very light green. I'm going to put that in my inner water or here. Then I'm going to pull it lower on top of the lashes. Yes. Then grabbing a tiny brush into this green. I'm going to plop that on top. So not really in my waterline, but more on top of the lash line. And hoping it kind of grabs hold of the pencil before it has completely dried. Yes, I think that's fun. So let's pack it a little bit lower as well. I usually don't do these types of looks, but I think it's fun. So let's do the same here. You could even use this if you don't have a light green. I think you can also do this with a yellow. So I also have, for instance, the yellow from a ColourPop Punch. I think you can use that one as well. It will be a little bit more yellow than green, but that does not really matter. I think that will be fun too. If you have sensitive eyes, maybe you should not do this. Or what you can do is spray, because you can also spray a matte. If you want to pack a matte underneath your eye, but your eyes are sensitive, just spray it. It's one of the reasons that I spray my shimmers, to make sure it doesn't go poof, you know? So that you kind of, I don't know, stick it into place. So I'm going to finish off the look now with, where is it? So I have here the yellow from ColourPop. I'm really lightly using it because I don't want it to be yellow. This is the Catrice It's Easy Tattoo Liner in black. For mascara, Lord and Barry in Alchemia. For falsies, the Sosu in Kylie. For lipstick, L'Oreal Rouge Signature in I Stand. And that completes the look. So this is how the look turned out. I like it. I like it with that pop of blue. I usually don't do something like that, but I do really, really like how it turned out. And I get it. I get why people love a color or a look like this so much. You know, just have a neutral upper part and then a colorful bottom, basically. So yeah, this was the last look of the video with the Taurus palette from BH Cosmetics. If there are color combinations that I haven't done yet, let me know. I do want to pair it with the Pisces one, so do a video where I use both. Let me know if that is of interest to you. And because I now have 4 minis and 1 large Zodiac palette, I can also do a palette bingo combining them all. Let me know if that is something that you want to see. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to sign off. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you soon in my next one. Bye, guys.